Welcome to Oracle APM tutorial series. In this video, I would like to show you how to create user-defined attributes in Real User Monitoring and demonstrate how you can use that data collected by those custom attributes in the APM Trace Explorer. My name is Yutaka Takatsu. I am one of the product managers in Observer VDN Management product management team in Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. In this demo, I would like to show you the user-defined attributes, which is one of the capabilities that the browser agent has. Say you manage a shopping cart website, which is called WineSetter. You want to use the APM to monitor the customer's in-app behavior and analyze whether your website is successful or not. To do so, you first need to deploy the APM browser agent. And I have already instrumented the APM browser agent to the front end of this application, so I should be able to see the code from the client side. So let's start from verifying that. Here is the JavaScript that instruments the APM browser agent. And you manually insert the JavaScript code along with your data upload endpoint and public data key so that the spans will be generated and uploaded to your APM domain. And because this is a shopping cart website, the web page already has customers' purchase information, such as the dollar amount of the purchased product. You want to pick up that information too and include it into the span. And that can be done by defining the custom attributes. So here I have four custom attributes defined: cart value, checkout value, complete value, and journey phase. And the attribute journey phase takes a value from a function call, getJourneyPhase function that you can see below in the file. So the attribute calls the function and stores the returned value, which is the information of which phase in the user's purchase journey the customer currently is. And because this is a customer's purchase journey, the values are either search, login, add to cart, checkout, or order complete. And other three attributes, such as cart value, checkout, and complete value, they store the dollar amount from each phase. Now let's verify what values are captured using the browser's inspection tool. Close this once. So here in the WineSetter application, let's add some products. Going to the shopping cart. Now then open inspection tool once again. And go to network, click checkout. And in the name section, I see requests made for spans. These are the spans generated by APM browser agent and will be sent to the APM domain. Let's select one of them. So in the payload section under request payload, there's a span node. Expand that. This is one of the spans generated with this request. So let's review the span information. So you can see the span ID, the kind is client, and the name is Ajax front store checkout. This is because the span was generated by the Ajax call. And there's also a trace ID. Now expand the attributes node. Scroll down a little bit. Here you can see the default APM RUM metrics, such as AJAX download time or AJAX first byte time, which are the values captured by the browser agent. And along with these default values, you can also see the custom values. So the cart value is 135 and 38. I also see the journey phase, which is 2 added to cart. These key value pairs are sent to APM so that later you can use them for analysis. Now let's see this in a Trace Explorer. And here is the Trace Explorer. The traces from the web transactions are already loaded in the screen. So let's click the trace at the top of the list to see the details. And because the web event was an AJAX call, which does not fully load a new page, the trace type is marked as partial update. Now let's click the second span, which says checkout, to see the span details. So you can see the operation name is Ajax checkout, and kind is client. This is the same information you saw in the browser inspection tool. And here is one of the custom attributes, which is a cart value. The dollar amount is 135.38, which was the value I purchased on the website. So this was also captured and included in the span. And down below, this is another custom attribute, journey phase. So you could see these custom attributes were captured by the browser agent, included in the span, sent to the APM domain, and allows you to view in Trace Explorer. Let's close this window. Go back to Trace Explorer. Now let me open a saved query. So this is a custom query that filtered the traces for those only having values in journey phase attribute, and also grouped by the journey phase. The query result is showing a summary of the user journey in the application in terms of the purchase process. So during this time, 36 customers visited the website, and 36 of them logged in, and 31 of them added something to the cart, and 19 of them checked out, and 17 of them completed the order. So the number of sessions in each phase is decreasing, going from the top to the bottom. And remember, you also collected the dollar amount from each phase, and the total values are also calculated and displayed in the view. So looking at the values, you can tell that potential revenue was lost as they go through the process. An UpDex score is also clearly in the view. And I can see the UpDex of the checkout 0.5. An UpDex score value that is below 1 indicates the user was not satisfied on the page performance. So for some reason, users were not happy at the checkout process, and that could be the reason that some customers left the website at this phase. From here, using Trace Explorer feature, you can narrow down to the checkout phase and investigate the reason why the users were not happy with this service. This concludes the demonstration of creating and using user-defined attributes in Real User Monitoring. We have more videos discussing and demonstrating APM features, so please see the description of this video to find links to other APM tutorial videos. Thank you for watching.